responsibility for yourself, things would be difficult to enforce. So having said that, for enforcement of IP asset, every country has some way out, but per se there is no specific way out to enforce an IP unless there is a total collaboration. You know, for example, you know, we cook food in our house. Everybody, maybe a man is cooking a chicken biryani, I am cooking a chicken biryani. Ingredients are same, but how the collaboration, how the proportion of ingredients are mixed, that adds to the taste of the biryani. At the same time, the person who is making it, how much he has the intention of making a good biryani for the, you know, people at their house. So that all impacts a better dish coming out of your hand. Similarly, for enforcement, unless there is a will from your side, even if we have a good law, even if we have good collaboration, nothing is going to move forward. So in US, unlike other countries, because in US IP has been of importance for time immemorial now, so there has been a good, I would not say it's a perfect system out there, because still with so much of collaboration system established, there is counterfeiting still happening in US, but still system is very much in place. So like in US, just to curb this issue of counterfeiting, the constitution itself talks about the importance of IP. Similarly, here also we have laws which talks about IP. So there are a few things that requires for a better enforcement mechanism. What are they? Deterrent level of penalties, as man was talking about, the amount of fine. You won't believe, in US for a trademark or a copyright infringement, the fine is up till up to 200, it's around 2 crores of Indian value. And it, the infringement go up to 3 years. So that is the level of penalties imposed on a person who is doing counterfeiting stuff. Similarly, there are enhanced penalties. Suppose somebody, person is being caught doing the same thing again and again, so the penalties go just doubles the amount for the first time. So that is something which, you know, does a deterrent effect to the people who are doing the counterfeiting activity. Then there are federal and state cause of action, meaning that even if there is a national law which governs the enforcement, then there is a state law which governs the enforcement of IPR. Then sentencing guideline, this is optional, but in many cases where the issue has taken to a very large scale, then there could be a possibility. Then there are specialized enforcement unit, agencies all across. The yellow one is not really. Apart from that, you know, we in US we have a very specialized unit which is called, which is under Department of Justice. It is called Computer Crime and Intellectual Property Section. Sorry, I am having a, you know, sore throat. So IPR penalties are regularly reviewed. We keep checking every year. You know, there is a discussion with the law enforcers, with the policy makers, to see how we can, you know, enhance this, you know, take care of this menace of counterfeiting and piracy. Whether the monetary fee is right amount, or it should be increased, or it should be decreased. Whether the length of imprisonment is the right, or we should increase it further to curb this counterfeiting issue.